Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Kelvin here. Today, I'll be sharing with you what is my purpose of saving money, and hopefully, it can also inspire you. When I was young, my parents used to tell me, if you want something, you will have to work hard for it, whether it's a PS2, or a new laptop, or just a trip to Taiwan. And growing up, it was carved deep within my mind that whatever they have wanted, I would have to work hard for it. Every time I save the needed amount, I have that sense of achievement. You have worked hard for something, and now all you need to do is just take out your cash and exchange for the reward. After that, every moment was spent on enjoying that reward. It is how a Mount Everest climber would feel. Every night, he would dream of that day where he conquers the peak, and he would prepare for days, weeks, months. The training was tough, but he didn't mind it one bit. Then, on the day itself, he climbed the mountain step by step until he finally reached the peak. He had conquered Mount Everest. He watched the sunrise, took some photos. All his months of training, blood, sweat, tears were all for this moment. But now he has gotten it. What is next? It is the same feeling after I've owned a PS2 for a few months. The excitement would die off. What's next? What else could bring me the same excitement? And so I look for my next target, my next Mount Everest, and I climb on, to which later I found out was just a hamster wheel. The problem is, we do not realize that throughout this process of earning and spending, we are just exchanging our lives for the things that we want. From graduation up till retirement, we have about 45 years of our lives which we will be working. And if we are so lucky that we get to live up till 80 years old, that's about half of our lives which we will be grinding to afford the things that we have always wanted. Things that will give us temporary happiness. When you are 40 or 45 years old, in the middle of your life, you wake up one day, look into the mirror, and you will see yourself old and wrinkly. And you will ask, huh? When did I become so old? What had I been doing all this while? Because, you see, all your life, you have been working a 9-to-6 job to chase after the things that you have always wanted. The PS2 which I bought, it was bought by working 3 months during school vacation. The new iPhone, 2 weeks of my life. The trip to Taiwan, going to work on cold February mornings instead of sleeping in, was well worth it. And little by little, we sell away our lives. Every day, we spend 9 hours in the office. Every week, 45 hours, and in 1 year, we sell away 2,600 hours of our lives by working. Working hard, getting our paycheck end of the month, earning a promotion, rising up the ranks so that we can afford bigger and better things. All this time, time that could have been better spent elsewhere. Imagine one day you are 60 years old when you and your spouse are already old. Your children have all grown up. Ask yourself this. Was it worth it? Was working hard every day for the best part of your life worth it? Or would I have wanted to spend the time with my parents who by then may or may no longer be around? With my spouse who by then are old and wrinkly? Or spending on doing things which I truly enjoy? Alan Watts, a famous philosopher, once said, if you say that money is the most important, you'll spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like in order to go on living. That is, in order to do the things that you don't like doing. And that's just stupid. The money which you have spent on buying a new iPhone every year in your 20s, was it worth it? Or would you rather use that money to buy an additional 2 weeks of your life? You may be like, huh? What do you mean? Buy my life? How is that possible? Once in a while, during weekdays when you are not working, you will sometimes see people jogging around or just walking the dog. And you will ask yourself, how is that possible? How are they so relaxed? Don't these people have to go to work? I remember seeing it all the time and I was kind of envious. Like, how come I have to work so hard to get the things that I want and here they are in their 30s, already enjoying life? You can give yourself all kinds of excuses like, of course they can enjoy life. They are born rich. Or they have landed a nice job which pays them 10k a month. While I don't have that kind of luck. But did you know that about 68% of millionaires are actually self-made? 24% have a combination of inherited and self-created wealth. That means that in one way or another, 90% of the millionaires have worked hard to get to where they are now. The hard truth is, no one is born at the same starting line. We can be born rich or we can be born poor. But what we do when we are alive, how do we choose our path, is entirely up to us. Whether you want to be working hard for your money, or just sitting at home watching Netflix all day long, or enjoying life on the Monday morning walking your dog, it is entirely up to you. You will be like, how is it possible to not work when I need those money to buy the things that I want? You see, many people have worked hard all their lives to buy the things that they have wanted. Cars, house, annual vacation, and so on. Mary Renaud, a writer, once said, money buys many things, the best of which is freedom. We can buy many things, but the best thing in life, which many people can't afford, is to buy our own freedom. Again, you'll be like, what do you mean freedom? I'm totally free. I'm not locked up in a cell and I can do the things that I want. But then, don't you see, you still have to go back to work the next day, the next week, the next year. You still have to go back to work your entire life until you can no longer work. And isn't it because you are not free, you are just chained to your job. And the only way to free yourself is by having enough money to buy your freedom. So then, how much do you need to be free? What is the price tag? The calculation is pretty simple. Let me show you. Let's say my expense is 2k a month. Then in order to not have to work for a month, I will need 2k of savings in my bank. If I don't want to work for a year, I will need to have 2k for 12 months. That's 24k to be free for 1 year. Let's find out more. Let's say I'm 30 years old right now and I die at 80. If I want to be free my entire life, that's 50 years of 24k in order to not have to work. Assuming that inflation doesn't exist, I would need 1.2 million to be free my entire life. So now you see why not everyone can buy their freedom, because it is too expensive. Remember that 1.2 million doesn't include your house, your car, your children. It is just your daily expense. So then you'll be like, wow, how can anyone afford their freedom unless they are born rich? Of course, there are ways. Some people will start their side business. Every day after work, they just head to their computer and work on their side business till late at night. But some people would say, I'm tired after work, I can't start another side business. Then some people would just work harder so that they can get a pay raise or earn a promotion. But that would take years. By then, you'll be in your 40s if you're lucky. And if you quit your job, you will still lose your income. Others will just buy the lottery ticket, hoping to get lucky and win that $12 million first prize. But what are the chances? According to Sidley, the chances is around 1 in 14 million. As the Hunger Games Effie would say, may the odds be ever in your favor. Which brings me to my final way of earning our freedom. And you might have guessed what it is, because that is the name of my channel. The easiest and surest way of buying our freedom is by investing. Pretty simple, you do not have to work extra hours, you do not have to wait another 20 years, and you do not have to rely on luck. And you already have all the money you need to start investing. There's an article by Mr. Money Mustache that's titled "The Shockingly Simple Math Behind Early Retirement." He found out that it's not about how much you earn, it's about how much you save and invest that will determine your freedom. Let's say if you invest nothing, then you will work your entire life. But if you invest 5% of your income, you will need to work 66 years before you can be free. Let's bring it up a little. 10% of your income, you cut off 10 years of working. How about investing 30% of your income? You only have to work 28 years. But that's not enough, isn't it? Let's go all the way down to which I feel is a manageable amount, because I'm personally doing it. You invest 55% of your income and you could retire in about 15 years. Let's put it in perspective. So maybe you have just graduated and is 25 years old right now. By investing 55% of your income, you can retire by 40 years old. Just imagine that by 40 years old, you don't have to go to work every Monday to Friday. You can spend time with your kids. You can walk the dog every Monday morning. Do the things that you truly enjoy or travel around the world because you no longer have to go to work the next day. Letting your money work for you rather than you working for your money is how you can be free. But then, there are a lot of people who do not want to invest. They would think that investing is risky. What if I lose all my money? Then, everything that I worked for, it would be for nothing. Let me show you something. This is the S&P chart for the past 90 years. You will notice that there are many ups and downs every year. But if you look at the big picture, over the long term, the market will always go up. In fact, the market has delivered a 10% average return for the past 90 years. That alone tells you investment is not as risky as you think it is. But then, why do you hear so many people losing money in the stock market? It is due to one simple reason: greed. People always want to get rich quick, so they would try trading. Buy low and sell high, but instead they bought high and sold low. But instead, if you have bought safer investments like index funds or dividend stocks, you'll be earning a steady 10% every year and enjoying your retirement with minimal stress and minimal risk. So learn how to invest, because if you avoid investing, you are just playing not to lose and you do not get to win. But by investing, you are playing to win, and when you win, you earn your freedom. There will be one day in our life when we are old and wrinkly, and we look back and reflect. Did I enjoy my life? The Guardian had an article which summarized the top 5 regrets most people have, and among them, I wish I had the courage to live a life true to myself. I wish I hadn't worked so hard, and I wish that I had let myself be happier. So if you want to avoid investing and work hard your entire life, make sure that you enjoy it, because our life is just so short. The graveyard is the richest place on earth, because it is here that you will find all the hopes and dreams that were never fulfilled. If you do not want to work your entire life and you want to enjoy life, you have to do something else other than just working hard. Warren Buffett once said, "If you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die." So whether it's starting a business or just investing, do something, and in 5 to 15 years time, you can finally afford to be free. You can't live at all unless you find a way to live now.